Hey guys, it's Richie from Fretjunkiestv and we are back. In this upload, we are going to be looking at how to play like Jimi Hendrix with three simple chord embellishment ideas. This will evolve into probably a series of lessons, but for now we're going to kick off with these just a few ideas. It's really going to set you down on the path of playing like Jimi Hendrix. I really believe this. I think I've kind of cracked the code. Take a listen to this. This is just a little progression I played with using these ideas, and this is something that's come natural to me. Really kind of pushing on with pentatonics and chord shapes underneath. Okay, take a listen. We'll jump into the video. Okay guys, we're gonna dive straight in. Okay, tune that guitar down half a step. You need to be there for Jimmy, and you need to be there for this lesson. We're not going to dive into Jimmy's tone. That's going to be coming up. I've got a really good video coming on that soon, but you know, I digress. We're going to jump straight on with this video, okay? We're going to be playing in A major. I'm calling it as I see it for any keyboard warriors out there. We're going to be playing in A major, and the first thing we're going to want to think about is our A bar chord, right? First thing we're going to want to do is we are going to want to get the thumb up there. We're going to want to probably drop that finger down and be playing our A like that. This will become apparent why we do this very shortly, okay? So if we're playing A major, this is all going to be based around the pentatonic. You must have a pretty good understanding of the pentatonic to apply this lesson. So if we've got the A major, we want to think of A major pentatonic. Well, to play A major pentatonic, we just drop back 1, 2, 3 frets, okay? And then we just play a straight pentatonic there. But we resolve to the A, okay? Okay? Now, from this position, we want to move to the second position of that pentatonic, if that makes sense. So we'd go up to the second position, starting on the F sharp. Okay? And in that is our A chord, right there, okay? Now, I'm not classically trained in any way at all, and I believe this is how I've worked out my way of playing guitar and embellishing runs and licks into chords. And I got a real strong feeling Jimmy might have done the same, because what feels natural to me to play this way, I see that obviously Jimmy does a lot, you know? And I think this has kind of happened with his playing, you know? He's explored these shapes within the chords, and that's where your embellishments come from, okay? So from the A, we got some real nice ones straight away from underneath there. We can, okay? So keep the bass note. Okay? And then from there we can also do, he does a lot of double stops. We can drop down. Okay, so we've got the 4th on the G string and the 5th on the B string, and thumb in the thick E. And then we're going to hammer on onto the 6th on the G string. Okay? And then from there we've also got... okay, and if you think of that, like I told you, this is really important. Think of the second shape of the pentatonic, starting from the F sharp, yeah? So all we're doing is we're highlighting bits of the pentatonic. Okay, and that will work in any major context, any major chord you play. So if we go up to a B. Oh, sorry. It's the same thing. You need to like I said, you do need to understand the pentatonics for this, but the chords work right within that pentatonic shape, okay? So that's how I would think about a major pentatonic starting on the thick E string. These are just some real simple, quick embellishments straight out the chord. One in a major context. So then if we go to a minor, think of exactly the same thing, and we are now going to stay in, as I said, in A major, and we're just going to drop down to the relative minor. Okay, now from the minor here, just think of minor pentatonic, and maybe add in, you know, maybe add that in. You don't need to though. So you really got to get that kind of like bass call and response going on. That's kind of what I see and hear a lot in Jimmy's playing, okay? He's not just playing straight chords, he's playing the chords and he's highlighting the chords in no particular order, and not aiming for any particular notes, that's what makes it kind of more psychedelic and kind of flow through. It is worth saying as well, you know, with the Jimmy's tone thing, if you get a vibe in this and a good fuzz and reverb and echo, man, you can really get psychedelic. If you look back, you'll see plenty of videos. I'll try and drop something up in there where I've kind of explored this. But yeah, so if we're in the minor, just think of the minor pentatonic, man. You can do some licks like... So we got there on coming out of the F sharp minor, we've got... Okay, so that would be the second to the fourth to the second, okay? On the A string, second, four, A string on the D. And then... I don't actually know what I play. I just try not to think. And all I'm doing is keeping that minor shape, but just, you know... I could have led then actually really nice back into the A, right? And that's what happens. This is all in the A, but I've just dropped down to the minor, and this is why the actual lesson's working nicely, okay? Thinking about progressions and how to link chords will be a different kind of lesson coming in the future, but I'm just showing you in context, okay? So we got the A, the major shape, coming out of the major shape, right? We can... And these are all embellishments right where your hand is stationed, okay? Okay, so that's a minor. And these are working off the E string, okay? And the same will apply if you drop your bar chord now down to the A string. And I'll show you what I mean now, okay? So let me think about this. Now we're gonna go into a minor position, yeah? And just starting from the A string. Okay, now how do I think about that? I think about that as the first position in the minor pentatonic coming out of the E, F, F sharp, yeah? So. This is how I think about it, and I look for embellishments just there. I mean, I explore a little bit higher. But for the most part, whenever I'm kind of there and I'm trying to flow through it, I always kind of stick close to where the chord is, and I find you'll hit more pleasing notes, you know, as you're passing them. So yeah, let's recap. We're in the minor, which is the same as up here, right? But now we've got different notes to play with. The same notes, but different area. So it's gonna sound different. So one we could look at would be the 9, 12, And then that's on the A string. Then we'll do a double stop, which would be the 9 on the D and G. And then hammer to the 11 on the D. He uses that a lot. That would be a different lesson again. Sorry, going out of context. So that's applying the minor from the A string. Again, that's going to work anywhere. So if we're in B minor. Exploring that first position from the minor pentatonic, and this time talking about B. And with a chord underneath. So, you know, as I said earlier about your effects, if you've got your effects in there as well, and you want to kind of, the dynamics is a big thing. Skip off some of the strings really lightly, dig in another place. And that kind of approach with a vibe and a wah and an echo and verb, you're going to get all the liquid, you know, unless this is it's right in there. So we've looked at the major from the E. We looked at the minor. From the E string. And we've looked at the minor from the A string. And if we look at the A, probably easier up here. Okay. Well, the way this one's a little bit more funky, if you like. But I still try and think of it as, if I'm playing A there, I still try and think of that as F sharp minor pentatonic. See how close it is? Because it's the same, right? But I don't want to be playing my embellishments going. I mean, it works. I want to try and play them close to where the chord is. So. If we do it in E, from the E, I would think of the C sharp minor pentatonic, which would be the E major pentatonic. And I'm going to do the same thing. First position of the C sharp minor, okay? There was a couple of other notes in there. That note I added in, okay? I added that note in. Go to the minor. Back up to the major. Minor. And that there is just utilizing those ideas, all right? Now, the idea with this and the way to make it sound, you know, bigger is explore more outside of the close areas of the chord you're playing. So a prime example, A, yeah? Now, instead of just playing, okay, I want to try and think, why don't I take that further up and make that more exciting? So again, knowing your pentatonics is you must, okay? And I'm thinking of the A. And that's just an A there, right there, okay? So, and that's coming out of the pentatonics. Back into the minor. Passage. I'm just cruising, man. You know, I'm just cruising through the pentatonic, cruising through the chords. Choosing the chords to play will come in the next lesson. But for this lesson, this is just really trying to show you how to start embellishing your way through chords and playing licks and runs that really work with the chords that you're playing. Okay. So that, in a nutshell, is kind of what this lesson is going to be about. We've looked at major from the E string, minor. Minor from the A string and major from the A string, okay? There's loads to go out of that. I just get lost in that kind of style of playing. But all for the main part, all I'm doing is using them ideas. And as I said, I'm not classically trained in any way. I've put a shitload of effort into my playing. And this is kind of where I see my progression has got me to. I understand theory, but you don't need to understand too much for this kind of playing. You know, good understanding of your pentatonics and then linking up notes from the pentatonics, and you'll see all the chords right in there. All those chords, you know, the major chords that we know. When I say major, I mean major and minor, but I'm not talking about augmented chords and all that. I'm just talking straight chords, yeah? They're all there, all in the pentatonic, okay? So I would suggest working on your major embellishments. And then work on your minor embellishment. So once you've completed that progress on the fixed string, drop down to the A string and look at your chords there. So, okay, that's the same as that, right? We've just got an F sharp minor. And look at your embellishments there. Look at the A shape, okay? The major, sorry, embellishments. And then we've dropped down to the E, starting on the A string. Okay, and you'll start seeing how they all link up. So yeah, practice that, go through that. See if you can kind of find your own embellishments. Stick strict at first to just straight pentatonic. And then in the next lesson, we're going to start looking at some other bits that you might use. But for now, yeah, these are there's actually four ideas. Four ideas to make your playing sound more like Jimi Hendrix. I don't know, man. To me, it does, you know. And like I said, the tone is a huge, huge rabbit hole that, you know, is for another lesson. But get this kind of under your belt at first, and then the pedals and all that are just a way of adding spices to your food. That's how I see it, you know. Get your craft tight, and then work on your tone afterwards. You know, a lot of people put too much work into their tone and not too, enough work into their playing. Okay, I hope you could take some from this, guys. I really do. This is like this is really exciting for me because I finally figured out how I'm going to explain it to you guys without breaking down all the theory, and just keep it as nice as it can and enjoyable for you to play, okay? If you're new here and you've made this to the end of the video, first off, thank you. If you could like, subscribe, and share for this video, it would mean a lot to me. I don't run a Patreon page or anything like that, but these videos take me a lot of time. So I'm going to hype the link in a donation kind of tip jar thing. If you guys can, you know, find it in you to drop a tip, that'd mean a great deal to me, you know? Times are tight right now for all of us. Some people are doing really great, some people ain't, you know, and any donations to the channel really help me out. They really do. And for all the people who have donated so far, thank you so much. It means a massive deal to me, okay? This is Richie from Fretjunkiestv. Thanks for being here. Peace to all. Richie. Boo.
Live on, Jimmy.